Hello friends and welcome back. In the last class we have started the unit number 1 in which we discussed the important topics from the unit number 1, and in this lecture we are also continuing the same unit and discussing the two major topics of the same unit. So these topics are the recent trends in tractor design, secondly force and torque analysis of tractor. These two topics are prime important in this chapter because recent trend in tractor design tells you about that how the tractor, from where, if we see the history, the tractor when it just started in 18th century, what are the changes have came now till now, and what are the recently we are going to use it, how the tractor has been changed now, what are the things which are to be considered while manufacturing the tractor. And second is force and torque analysis of a tractor. Basic force and torque analysis, like how much force is required on the rear axle and the front axle. So those are the things which we'll discuss in the unit. So if I check out the recent trends in the tractor, so as I told you that we started long back in the tractor history. So but till now we have changed so much. Now the tractors are controlled without even human, they are GPS controlled. So till now we have reached to that time. So what is the first thing that we are going to discuss, and it is power generation, that is engines. So whatever the new innovations or the new technology is added into the engines, the same is to be added into the tractor's engine. So whether it is a car engine, diesel car engine, or the tractor engine, although their capacity is changed, their power is different, but the advancement which have been included into the car's engine, diesel car engine, the same is to be added into the tractor engine. So it is completely same. So everywhere in the world this power generation system are to be enhanced so that the maximum output can be get from the engines. Then the second is transmission. It's the same thing, that if any advancement is made into the vehicle industry or automobile industry, the same is to be implemented into the tractors. So if I would say, we haven't seen any tractor which is moving beyond 50 kilometers per hour or 60 kilometers per hour because they are not designed for it. Tractors are designed for the high traction power and for doing the heavier works, but our cars are not used for that. Similarly, ideally your tractor speed is 40 kilometers per hour and 15 kilometers are in the reverse side. And it is provided with the 8 or 10 speed gears are provided, 8 to 10 depending upon your work. You should decrease down your gear and you can enhance its power. Vice versa is also true. If you wanted to move the tractor on the road, so you need to go into the 10th gear. So it is depending. Nowadays this versatility is there, but earlier it was not there in the transmission system. Then the next one is but manufacturer have incorporated partially synchronized or fully synchronized top gear with many speeds for the tractor. So it is optional four-wheel drive. So depending upon your application, the four-wheel drive can be included into the tractor design. So it is now. Secondly, a dual clutch and live PTO has to be included. It is again attached with your transmission system. Your dual clutch system means dual clutch, one clutch is for your engine and one clutch is for your PTO shaft to be controlled, and live PTO means your tractor is working and meanwhile you can use the PTO. So these are the advancement which are used in the transmission system. Earlier your transmission system was separated, your PTO was separated, so either of one will work, either your engine would work, or means your engine would travel, or your PTO would work. But nowadays you can use both at a one time. So this is the advancement. Next is your chassis design. So similarly, the chassis design is heavier and used for the heavier works. It would be used and it can bear the maximum load and vibration because tractor is designed for that. So whatever the chassis changes has been made into the vehicle industry, the same is to be implemented in the tractor and the trucks even. Then if I say that, see, the one of the example, the seat cover, the seat is now kind of a this, so that it should be comfortable for the driver. Earlier the seat was made of completely solid, no cushioning is provided, it was made up of steel, correct? So nowadays we are providing the cushioning effect so that they can absorb some vibrations. Then the next one is hydraulic system. This is the, you know, power of the power of your tractor is depending, power of your tractor is depending upon the hydraulic system, because whatever the implement is provided onto the tractor, this is directly connected with the hydraulic system, correct? And this hydraulic system should be carrying, having the enough power to carry on all the agricultural or earth moving works when it is attached onto the tractor. So hydraulic system. Then the next is traction improvement. Traction improvement, there are two ways to increase the traction improvement. The first one is whether when the traction is lesser, means your road is there, plain surface is there, so you can use your tires. So tires are enough, pneumatic tires are enough. But if your track is not smooth, so you can use the tracks even, correct? So they are to improve your traction improvement. They are used for the traction improvement, whether the pneumatic tires or the track tires, correct? So these are the traction improvement. Then the next one is comfort and safety. So whatever earlier there was no safety, if I talk about the 18th century or the starting of the 19th century, even then the safety for the driver wasn't there. So if anyhow your tractor just roll over, if I wanted to show you this, yeah, if your tractor just roll over, then it is defined that the tractor would be onto the driver and driver would be crushed and it is not survivable, and the driver would definitely die. But nowadays we are providing this ROPS called as a rollover protective structure. So this, and plus it is effective when it is used with the belt, otherwise not, plus this belt. So whenever the rollover takes place, correct, this frame plus the belt would save the driver. Earlier it wasn't there, correct? So in the modern tractor, this paddle is replaced with an electrical switch. So it's a comfort. So it is, to pressing a pedal it takes much more force, but to pressing a switch, nothing compared to the pedal. So comfort and safety is to be taken care. And the second one is four wheel locking differential. So locked differential or open differential. So if you wanted to see what is the difference between the locked and open differential, you must go to the link given in the description of this video. So you must go there and find out what are the different type of differential that we are using. So it's for the comfort and it is for the safety. Actually, it is for the safety of tractor as well as for the driver, correct? Then the next one is levers and switches. So levers and switches, first of all, they should be approachable to the driver, the levers, whether the levers or switches. But most of the levers is converted into the switches. So because it is safe, secondly, easy to work onto them. Clear? So levers and switches. And the last one is GPS navigation. Nowadays, this is a newer technology. Nowadays, the driver just sitting into the room and controlling all these tractors or the machinery by sitting through its computer. And it just set a map onto the ground and the tractor will move onto that given path without the driver, correct? So this is the newer technology. GPS and navigation is provided onto the tractor. Yeah, so these are the recent trends that are implemented in the tractor for the safety, for the performance enhancement, and the advancement in the technology. Now the next topic is force acting on tractor on move, means the speed and torque analysis of a tractor. So if I wanted to check out this first image, just see this first image, what is happening in this case. This is the engine at the front. The power is provided to the rear wheels. It is V0 means your engine is moving translatory motion in this direction towards the left, and tires are rotating in this side. So speed analysis is not called as a V0, and whatever the tire rotation is given you the V0, the tire rotation is 2 pi omega, means its omega is what, or 2 pi n is what, your rotation, your RPM. You can see here 2 pi n, so pi dn, sorry, pi dn w, w mean, nw means your RPM of your wheel, and ne stands for your RPM of your engine. So engine RPM would be more, and it is converted to by using the final drive, the RPM is reduced by a factor which is called Q. Now this Q factor is different in different cases, correct, depending upon your final drive system. So if you wanted to check out the final drive system, you must go through my previous lectures. You can find it out easily. So the final, there's a connection between tire and a engine power through the final drive, and there are gears on the final drive which reduces your speed. So that's why you can see the NW is always lesser than the NE. Means NE, NW stands for your rotation RPMs of your wheel, and NE stands for the RPM of your engine. So it is your travel speed would be pi d n by q. Q is a factor through which your RPM is reduced through the final drive. So this is a speed analysis of a tractor. Then the second one is your torque or force analysis. And torque and force are interrelated to each other through the diameter d. So if I would say the engine is producing the torque, this engine is producing the torque TE, you can see over here, and the drive wheel producing the TW, and similarly this Q is a factor. This Q is a factor. Why it is Q is inside? Because whenever the RPM is reduced, the torque is increased. So that's why if your engine torque is lesser, but at the tires the torque is heavier or the higher, because there's a final drive which is in between the engine power and the tire. Correct. So the when the equilibrium takes place, it means what is the equilibrium requires that this torque is equal and opposite to the movement of the soil reaction. See what he says that. So this is the soil reaction, which is called the H. It is a soil reaction, and this is the P, which is pushing force in the backward direction. So this will be in equilibrium. That is, that can be that only then the tractor will move in the forward direction. Correct. So what is the moment? It is H into this direction into D by 2. This is the distance. Force into distance is your moment. Force into distance. So this H is your force and D is your distance. D by 2 is your distance. So that will be your torque on wheels. Correct. That is your torque on wheels if it is the equilibrium condition. Then only the tractor will move in the forward direction. Clear? And TW can also be written as QTE from this relation. So H would be 2QTE by D. So this is your H, means the soil reaction or the reaction force which is taken onto the wheel, which is the solely responsible to move the tractor in forward direction. Correct. And then if the drawbar pull is equal to the soil reaction X, then this would be your equals to P. Means your pull, drawbar pull, which is pulling it backward, and soil reaction is in this direction, both are equal. So this will be your power. This is a drawbar pull, you can find it out. Clear? So this is all about your torque analysis. This is the power analysis. Power, we all know that engine power is T omega. Engine power is T omega, but omega can be written as 2 pi n. T e 2 pi n. So the drawbar pull into travel speed. Correct. So the power can be written as force into velocity. Power can also be written as force into velocity. So it's a drawbar pull P, which we derived in the previous, torque and velocity, which we derived in the speed analysis. So multiplying all these factors, we got the engine power or the drawbar power. Correct. So this is the power analysis of your engine. So this is the two topics that we discussed in the this today's lecture. The first one is recent trends in tractor design, then force, power and speed analysis of the tractor. So if you wanted to check my other videos, you must subscribe this Tiny Steps channel, as your previous lecture and further lectures would be on to the channel according to the date. Correct. Thank you and take care.